we're going to talk about here is a prelude to give you an idea of the importance of doing set-based processing rather than doing row-by-row processing. The challenge we face is that historically, programmers have historically liked to write things in paragraphs or chapters of code that dealt with one row or one object at a time. And this is, whilst it's great at producing functional code relatively quickly and meeting their objectives in terms of meeting the functional requirements of a program, it inherently is results in serial programs that will undoubtedly never scale when the data volumes get large, or if you're trying to exploit parallel techniques on big computers of the nature that we deal with now at Oracle. So we have this challenge in the industry where data sets are getting bigger, computers are getting bigger, computers are getting better at processing in parallel. Also, the computers are less likely to be I/O starved as they were historically when people wrote programs or went to school, because a whole generation of programmers have grown up thinking I/O was bad and done everything to avoid it. And now the game has changed. Data sets are big, very often in the millions or billions or even trillions of rows. Computers have got up to hundreds of even thousands of CPUs, and I/O with technologies like Exadata and in-memory computing has largely been mitigated. So it meant that things could run at CPU speed, and so we needed to start architecting code to run at CPU speed, and not just one CPU, but start to exploit all the CPUs. But the challenge is, in many cases, just even on small computers, the programs were done in an inefficient manner. And this is what we want to show in a very simple case of just how we can make a serial program, in fact, more efficient than someone's attempt at doing parallel processing, because it was being done in the right place. And what we're going to do here is demonstrate loading 20 million rows. And what I'm going to show is, and we're going to do this by a series of races, and we're going to race two types of racer. There's racer one and there's racer two. And racer one is using a dedicated connection to the database, just one connection, and bulk loading 1,000 rows at a time. The second racer is using a classic Java connection pool and is having 16 connections to the database, actually has 128 individual Java threads within the application. And what we're going to do is we're going to race them instead of in front of you and see who can load 20 million rows first. And as you can see, both processes are starting up. I mean, it's very apparent that if we actually look at the graph, you can see which racer is pulling ahead. It's the guy that's doing the array insert and using only one core. If we actually look at what's going on within the computer, you can see the machine that's doing one core is only using one process, and it's very evenly loaded. If you look at the host that is actually running, doing the pool of 16, you'll notice that we're getting more CPUs busy, but we've also got a lot of processes in wait states. And if you actually look at the CPU, you can see that the CPU utilization on the threaded case is actually higher than on the array case. Yet if we actually now start looking at the performance after the first race finishes, the first single thread was able to load 20 million rows in just over a minute. Now, we're going to stop the race in any second of time when it's finished, and then let's see what sort of time we were. If we'd actually gone with the threading model, it would have taken us 22 minutes to actually load the same 20 million rows. So if a system architected to use a connection pool and do everything one row at a time and actually use the Java pool, they'd have probably blamed the database and said the database couldn't load 20 million rows in an acceptable period of time. So you can see two different programming styles, again, all running on the same hardware. One works really well, one doesn't work very well, and is in fact 20 times slower. So in many cases, we say, well, you know, we didn't use up all the hardware on the other case, on the threaded case, so we should potentially give it some more connections to the database. So I'm going to increase the connections quite dramatically to the database. I'm going to give it 64 connections to the database, and I'm going to give 512 threads to the application server. So there's no shortage of connections, threads, or whatever. And I'm going to run the race again, and let's just see what happens. And again, we're seeing similar characteristics. We're throwing a lot more hardware, as you can see popping up. Here we go. But many of those processes, whilst busy, are all in a wait state. They're not actually doing the inserts. We've got no shortage of threads. We've got no shortage of processing. But you can see that the threaded model, because it's doing things lots one at a time, it isn't actually achieving any of its objectives of trying to make things work, because basically we're funneling effectively contention downstream to the database. Whereas the one that is running serial is running extremely efficient and is able actually to load rows into the database much faster in this case. And in fact, we're starting to see some interference where in fact the threaded one is actually slowing down the serial process. But you can see that we've shaved a little bit of time off the racer two. We're gonna get it to finish in about 13 minutes, and racer one is still taking about a minute to load 20 million rows. So that didn't show just throwing resources at the problem, it just showed that the programming model was worse. If we start to index the table that we're inserting and making it much more real world, let's rerun the race and see what happens at this point in time. As you can see, the anticipated times for the jobs are going to take a little bit longer. Even the one with the racer one with the array insert is taking slightly longer because we have to maintain that index. But it gets more interesting if we actually look at the second case, the threaded model with all those threads. And you can see that we're experiencing a lot more database contention inside the database, usually associated with TX index contention and buffer busy waits, as you can see here. And this is basically just us creating a program that builds inherent contention into the database at a later time. And very often we hear people saying, oh, it's the database's fault. It cannot scale, it can't accommodate the workload. Again, you can see a row by row programming paradigm is the challenge that we've got here. And you can see that basically, whilst we're putting lots of threads in motion, most of them are stalled because they're contending with each other. Whereas if we set up the workload to work in batches, we're not only saving code path, but we're eliminating contention because there's so few threads active in the game. So again, we're going to reproduce that. Basically, we need to learn how to deal with insets and think about CPU efficiency and how to mitigate contention. This is a very simple case. And you can see, again, we're orders of magnitude faster by doing it in using an array and a set-based programming method rather than single row at a time, and effectively manual or homegrown or homespun parallelism.